Hello and welcome to the lab. I know I've been quiet for a while, but there's many reasons. So, here's the lab as it currently is. And there's a reason that I haven't been quiet and everything. It's because I'm going to move the lab. If you can tell behind me, there's a lot of background noise, and I'm really tired of that showing up in recordings. There's also water noise and other things. So we're going to take all of the lab and move it to a spot that doesn't have any of these noise problems. I mean, it's really funny though, because this is located next to the Scrub Hub / N2T2 studio and everything. But that side's quiet, but I don't film the lab stuff in there. I film it in this room. So we're going to move all that out of here, and this is going to become art room and storage and things that don't need to worry about sound quality because it's like a control room, which was originally the intention of this. But yeah, so we got to move a lot of stuff. Yeah, there's some of that water noise. It's the washing machines draining and everything, you know. Go figure. That's how it works. But yeah, so you're hearing three noises at once right now. There is the dryer, a washer, and the air conditioning unit behind me. It's all quiet in the studio, but not out here, because there's no ceiling. And it'd be too expensive to put in drop ceiling, some soundproofing, although that would work. So here we are in the new studio. I'm not going to really show off the changes I've made because I've still got some design decisions about the stuff over there. But for the moment, I think the desk is good. So do we want a desk tour? I guess we can do a desk tour. It'll be simple because it's not quite what's going to be permanent. I'll make a good video on how to set up like a desk or something at some point. But let's walk over. So I've changed things a little bit because we're in a new location. But the main concept, I guess we can start with the drawers or something. You got the usual desk stuff, which is a funny label because there's almost nothing that's a usual desk item. Because we've got side snips, razor blades. Should be an X-Acto blade, but it's not here. The dental swab thingies, 10-pack pipettes. Because why not? Maybe that's not 10. Maybe it's more than 10. I don't know. Disposable pipettes, BNC to RCA and vice versa. Termination. And then this is almost usual desk items because we've got pens and stuff. But oh, look, this needs to live here. Oop. All right. You know, scissors, but then we've got like thermometer and, well, some of this is sane. Down here we have the mostly incorrect label. Precision tools no longer live here. Ziploc bags still live here. And the pole to this way while opening, I think I fixed the drawer, so it doesn't really matter. But it's got Ziploc bags. I mean, as far as the eye can see, this entire drawer is Ziploc bags. Because reasons. So we got the iron that lives here. You know, can use it, move the little plate that lives under it. Got to have the pointer nearby. The new magnify glass thing. I've been using it for some macro, though that might change. We have to see. But it's great. I recommend everyone have something like this if you don't have the Mantis magnifier and all that. Just, it's got a light. We'll show you that in a second. I got the Siglent because, of course, we do. Oh, we're getting a little bright. Burp. Wire. Well, it's dollar store wire. There's a few other things. I think some more wire might start living there. And these are storage, so they're not permanent. Altic Lansing speakers, because of course we have Altic Lansing speakers. Because you got to have some music in here. Storage. Lots of storage. And the... if I can get light up there. No! And the tech oscilloscope, because you need analog. Got to have analog. So, a good old Ciro. But here's my favorite thing in the world is switches. So we've got... two different switches, they're on different plugs in the wall, so they're technically safe, they're not daisy chained or whatever. And they're all labeled, because of course they're, except for the master on here, but that's fine. So we've got the two lights on it, as well as, you know, the master can turn off all the lights, you know, we just got the camera's light. And this lets us turn on, like, the magnifier, so it's got the crazy bright bulb. It's not daylight. This uses the old plasticky mount. This uses the old plasticky mount, and I can't fit the new daylight bulbs in there, so this old Cree that's incandescent-ish is living on there for the moment, but it will change once I can modify it. You can turn the iron on from here, as well as the fan and give it a new power supply. That's for when I'm soldering. I have like the little exhaust fan thing because lungs? I don't know. And then up here is the testy side of thing. The test side of thing. I don't want to say testy. I got the power supply, which is almost useless because it's grounded. Bench strip, which is great. The Siglent is actually now on it, but it's always going to be on, I guess. Hot glue, and then I've actually got an extra switch for the tech, because why not? This is what I'm using in lieu of having a power strip in the behind the desk. Seems easier. Down here we've got the, currently the media disc player we're using for music. Media disc? I always say that, media disc. I want it to be called a media disc, but it's a mini disc. Got the power strip, so it's actually cool. I like switches and feeling like you're some sort of launch station. So you turn the switch up on out there, and you have to turn this switch on. You have to turn that switch on, and that gives you power. Because I actually don't have the 5-volt standby routed to any part of this. That never happened for whatever reason. Maybe I'll buy some terminals and we can get 5-volt standby on front, so you only have 2 amps limited by that switch. But the theory is there. The wires are back there. It can be modded. Hot glue gun lives there, and the actual base station, because it's easy enough to reach to, but I don't need to. It's just, you're not fiddling with it that much. Over this side is where most things change. I used to have this wire shelf thing here to hold a few items, but that's not really necessary anymore because I've got a shelf. So all I really keep back here is the Mitutoyo calipers and the actual calipers and calculator, because you gotta have a nice calculator. Here's anything I'm currently working on, as well as the bench strip, which is going to be mounted better soon, but for the moment I like it being sideways. It's kind of fun. Helping hands. I guess the fan has to live here. It used to dangle from the wire thing with the adapter, but things have changed. All the scope probes live here, as well as audio jack and a few BNC cables type thing. Just the simple things. I have a whole collection of BNC cables elsewhere, but this is the fast access I'm going to probably use it thing. Over here lives the USB breakout cable, because you gotta have one. And then we've got a few. The rest are still packed, so I'm moving the desk, of course. So we've got most of the alligator clips, and then just storage, as well as our wonderful camera mount that allows me to have the camera overhead. It's great. But yeah, this is just basically storage and some scrap wire type thing, so we don't worry about that too much. And then down here, we've got the screwdriver scene, the leads for the multimeter hang there if it were here, and a label maker, and this old label from beginning of time says trash, and in fact the trash can still lives here. Got some hay wire here because, you know, construction. But yeah, I think that's my desk. What doesn't change too much is to the side of me is my Husky toolbox, which doesn't close because I fill it so full of stuff. But, you know, it's labeled, so we got the nice organized pliers. I'm kidding. Screwdrivers, which I like to keep organized to a degree. These have to be in a certain order, but this oversight doesn't. So I'm not really showing it because it's so bad. I don't like showing off. These are in order, and the rest is not. So it's the large pliers and spinning spanners. Or adjustable wrenches, I believe Americans call them. Hammer, stud finder, and then just whatever else you could possibly imagine. Fishing string, wire string, this thing, hot glue, sticks, so many cable ties, wall things, useless flashlight. And then from there, it's all the land of temporary. We don't show the land of temporary. Sort of the things that I kind of live with right now, but will change, I'm sure, when I figure out a better solution for the new area, is we got the repair box and anything I'm repairing or just storing, because storage. Scrap in progress, the new board that I'm scrapping parts from that's otherwise trash and, you know, recycle. Completed teardowns, every completed teardown that fits in a small box that's done in this house, which would be lab version 3, I think. This is lab version 4 now since I moved the desk, not house this time. And various little bits of attaching things to wall and such. Yeah, I don't know. I just love these little variety packs of picture hanging stuff, because why not?
So yeah, I think this is gonna work great for the desk. Oh yeah, I forgot to show the best part. You can show it sideways like this. We've got a little dingley arm, and we can open a window. So if it were daytime, I would have light in the outside world. What a crazy thought. And I like how the tech just holds that for me, so it stays right there. It's great. I can even open the window if I, you know, really wanted to. So I'm back to how... I didn't show the way. I'm back to how lab number one was, where I used to have a window behind me and all that fun stuff. Yeah, that was good old days. A lot of videos were shot there. So that's just been a quick little update on why I've been kind of silent and, you know, whatever, is because it's been way too hard to film. One of the main problems is that there was just noise everywhere. Hopefully I recorded that ultra I showed afterwards. If not, it's just, it was just way too loud. And so there was never a good opportunity to record, and when I did, there would always be something in the audio in the background. I didn't want that. There's actually, I don't think there's a single vent in this entire room I'm in, so it's pretty good. I can shut a few doors around me, and then this is the lab. It's an improvement, so, you know. I'll give you guys a better update. I want to do some videos on how to start your own lab, because you probably have some questions, whatever else, and this is not an ideal setup, but it's the setup I like. So, and that's an important thing, is you have to have a setup that's what you like. I'm sorry that the angle is so bad. It should be higher, but I really can't hold this camera like this. But thanks for watching, and if you're interested in seeing, finally, a rush of videos, subscribe. They will be here.